Bernice Ann Reed, and I was born on the 27th of April 1940, yonks ago. I believe a little private hospital in Victoria Park, which I've tried to research and I've not been able to find out much. That's what I was told. Mum and her siblings were born in Ravensthorpe, which is round further east than Esperance, right down south. Her father was Welsh, and he came on a free passage for a job in the mines at Ravensthorpe. And my mum's mother and the great aunt that I'm going to talk to you about later were two of 17. A significant part of my memories living in the city was my great aunt. We only ever called her auntie. She was a sister to my mum's mother, who was deceased before I was born. She had worked at the Palace Hotel first, but not for long, I don't think. And she was the head housekeeper at the Hotel Esplanade in Perth, not the Fremantle one. And auntie lived in. She had a lovely room on the first floor. I would pop in my working days when I was at Elder Smith's, I would pop in most mornings for morning tea, my morning tea break. She was very gracious. She was a real lady. And we'd sit and talk. We'd talk about anything and everything. But when we moved to West Perth, she used to come in a taxi fairly regularly, all dressed up, hat, gloves, and her little fur. And Mum would make tiny little sandwiches. And Auntie would take off her hat, take off her gloves, take off her fur, put it over the corner of the lounge. And I was scared stiff of this thing. And I just remember she was just so good to us and very, very humble, very gracious. I literally had to practice my manners before we went there. You know, I had to, Mum would set the table and set out the cutlery and say to me, you know, this is, if we get fish, this is for fish and this is whatever. And don't hold your cup with two hands. Say please and thank you. I'll never forget that. Well, having been there 40 years, and I imagine she was almost middle-aged when she started there, she accepted that she had to move, but she didn't want to. She really didn't want to. And so the exact year, I'm not sure, but she was probably at the Little Sisters of the Poor at Glenbelow for 5 or 6 years, no more, when she passed away. But that would have been 1971, and they pulled that hotel down in 1972-3. So, you know, sometimes things happen the way they do for a reason.